so loud. Such a good feeling to know the day is now. I've got a chance to be all that I can be. It's going to be a good day.
Well, hello and welcome once again to A New Beginning in Christ Ministries. I know I say this every Sunday morning, praise God, but if you think of something else for me to say, let me know. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. We've enjoyed so much in bringing these programs to you. And praise God, as we get, you know, we're getting starting to get older. We've been on this since 1991. Praise the
you
Lord.
You have.
Yeah. Praise God. Well, we've been on since 2002. Praise mm-hmm. God. So that's
18 years
going
for
on
us.
18 years, yeah. Praise God. So, but continuous, I might add, praise the Lord. And, you know, I just thank the Lord, praise God, that he's made a way that we can have these programs. Yeah, they're not cheap, praise God. But God has always made a way for us, praise God. Now, we're going to be studying this morning in Deuteronomy chapter 28. You know, some people think that the Old Testament has been done away with.
Mm-hmm.
But the New Testament is the fulfillment of the Old Testament. So if you don't know the Old Testament, you don't know what's been fulfilled. Praise
That's
the Lord.
True. I have a reading.
Yeah, say yeah.
About the Old and the New Testament.
Praise God.
That'll be my reading today. The Old and the New Testament. The new is the old contained. The old is the new explained. The new is in the old concealed. The old is in the new revealed. The new is in the old enfolded. The old is in the new unfolded. The new and the old are combined, that all their truths are intertwined.
Amen. That's good.
You know, I got that at one of our home Bible studies. A friend of ours gave that to us. Van Born.
Yeah, you can't have the old without the new, and you can't have the new without the old.
True.
Praise God.
True.
All of the prophecies that are in the Old Testament point toward a time when there would be a sacrifice that was acceptable unto God.
You know, even back in Adam's day, Adam knew that there would be one sin.
Yeah, and see, that's the whole thing. And all of those prophets would have loved to see what we're seeing and have been for the last 2,000 years, because that would have made everything that they were prophesying and talking about come into fruition. They would have seen it. But,
amen.
I mean, but see, they did all of that in faith, knowing that sometime, somewhere in the future, something's going to happen that's going to change the world. And that did. It was Jesus Christ, the birth of Christ, that now we have a sacrifice that's pure, that's acceptable unto God, whose blood can cover us and redeem us from all sin. Praise God. And I wish people out there, no matter where you are, no matter what sin that you're into, praise God, if you'll just come to Jesus and ask him to come into your life, praise the Lord, he will. And it just makes such a wonderful, wonderful life. Praise
Amen.
God.
You know, speaking of life, as we get older, gosh, so many, not only the changes in the world, but we're losing a lot of friends. My heart goes out to each and every one of them, but to each one of them, when we go, you and I leave thinking, I wonder what people will say about us.
Yeah,
you know, and things like that. You know what though? It's to stir our spirit. The Word of God stirs our spirit. Our life experiences, the loss that we feel when we lose a friend or someone we knew, or a friend died.
Yeah, when you lose somebody that's been close to you, it's always painful in a sorrow way,
yeah.
Praise God. And oftentimes the person that you lose, or their husband or wife mm. or children, praise God, you're there to help comfort them.
Yes.
And many times, they just, no matter how hard you try, at least for me, I can never do anything that I feel cheers them up or makes them feel better. Praise God. But
But
you just
got
to be there for his shoulder to cry on.
Just
sometime.
Let him know. Say, I'm here.
Yeah,
I'm here.
There was a, I got to tell this story about this lady who got to missing her son, and after a while he came in, and she said, "Where in the world have you been?" And he said, "I've been over helping Mr. Jones cry." He had lost his wife, and the little boy didn't know what to do, and he saw him sitting there in the swing crying. So he just crawled up next to him and helped him cry.
Praise what a God. Blessing.
And you know that, and that's all we can do. We can just help people cry. Praise the Lord. I love that story. Praise God.
That is a good story. Thank
it
you
is.
For sharing that.
We want to say hello to all of our friends out there. Mm-hmm. Praise God, especially over at Yardale, Durman. Praise God. I just love those people to death. Praise the Lord. And Don Dow and he had that congregation over there. Like all of us, these congregations are getting older.
Have you noticed that?
Yeah. You know, I look for an influx of young people, but I don't
there.
Think that the faith is out there that was there when we were younger. Praise
you know
God.
What they're calling faith now is entertainment.
It is.
In a lot
it
of
is.
Them, not
yeah.
all of them. But whenever I see lots of young people, I think, now what is drawing those that many young people in one spot? I hope it is the Word of God that they're using.
I do.
But too many times I've investigated, I've went, and it's been entertainment, period. I'm
to be
sorry
quite
for that.
Honestly, my hope is in Jesus Christ.
That's
I don't
it.
Have much hope for our young people. Praise God.
I believe as we get older, each generation gets further and further away from
they
God.
They do. I think about when we were in our youth, we used to have a lot of tent revivals. And
what was those others? Brush arbors.
Well, they were brush arbors. And we had preachers still riding on horses going from camp to camp. Mm-hmm. Praise God. And the people were so close. We mm-hmm. didn't have television. We didn't have those things, praise God. But we had each other, and we helped each other. And mm-hmm. you don't see that much anymore, praise God. Everybody wants to just go out and do their thing, watch television at night, do the thing with the computer, and keep the front door locked.
Well, you know, people are losing something very, very important, not only the act of conversation, carrying on a conversation, but human contact.
That's it.
People
praise
can
God.
They can live their whole life and never step outside. They can order their food in. They can have friends online. They can watch a movie. They don't have. They do everything on bank online.
Yeah.
They're getting where it's we're all self-contained.
They don't need anybody.
That's sad. That's scary.
See, that's so sad.
They don't know that they need anybody.
That's it. But, you know, and here's the hope that I have that at some point that people will dawn on the fact that they can't get through this life on their own. They need Jesus Christ to get through. Praise God.
He's the only
and
hope.
And you need people. Praise God. People keep you soft.
Yeah.
People keep you to where you can love somebody. Hallelujah. But when you get all off to be yourself and just close in, you get cranky and things, and you get the same thing all day, every day, never changing. Whereas if you're around other people or getting out, praise God, things change on a day-to-day basis.
They do. And I just want to say once again, I'm sorry for your loss, my friends, recently.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
We haven't forgot you. Our lesson today, is going to be in
Deuteronomy. You have a reading that...
Yeah, I have.
While you're getting that ready, we played some of the Happy Goodman family, praise God, and I hope you've been enjoying those. We're going to play another one today, praise God, maybe another one next week, but the old songs, I like the old songs, and of course, we were around all the time when the Goodmans were alive and doing well and all, and I always, always, always enjoy them so
Amen.
Much, praise
Amen.
God, and have the privilege we've met. The niece, Sandy's daughter. Is it Sandy? Praise God.
Well, I'm not for sure.
Yeah, she wrote...
Look for Me.
Look for Me.
Rusty Goodman wrote Look for Me.
Yeah, and that's one of the most beautiful songs mm-hmm. today. I just love that. We may have you sing that sometime.
I'd love to sing it sometime.
All right. Well, if you would, just go ahead with your reading, Carolyn.
Okay. Again, this is from your book of five-minute sermons. I love them. And you got more than one book. My God is able, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. That's Philippians 4:19. All of your needs, not just some, all. What a promise. And yet I see so many that walk around every day in sickness and poverty. I see every day those that try to make God conform to their way of life. I see every day those that seek to justify their lack of healing by saying, I believe in healing, and I'm waiting for God's time to heal me. Saints, that is not scriptural. 1 Peter 2:24 says, by whose stripes ye were healed. Past tense. Your healing is already taken place. So why are so many sick? Why are so many weak? Why do so many sleep before their time? There are two possibilities. Either God is wrong or you are wrong. I believe at this point I can safely say that it is not God's fault that people suffer so much misery. So I suggest that it is necessary that mankind look inward for the answer. God does not bless disobedience. You may find solace in your confession that you are a professing Christian. You may find comfort in confessing that you are saved and therefore can do no sin. You may even get so bold as to confess that God understands and will forgive all your sins. Read it again. Jesus said, not every one that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven. That's in Matthew 7:21. God is a jealous God. He said that. I'm merely repeating what he said. In Exodus 20:3, God said, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Now that seems pretty definite. When you find yourself worshiping false gods, and not much good is happening in your life, you really ought to stop and ask yourself why. Lying is a sin. There is no such thing as a white lie or a little lie. We should have by this time figured that out by the example the president has set. No situation should ever justify lying, never. Trusting God should be the answer. Believing Christians should know in their heart that God is able to bless those that do his will. Revelation 21:8 clearly states that all, I repeat, all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Not just big lies, not just lies that hurt other people, but all lies, great and small. So now that we are in agreement, let me ask you another question. Why is it Jesus reason enough to celebrate? Isn't the gift of his birth the reason for the season? How can we mix this wonderful birth of Christ with the myth and a lie in the very same breath? How can we confess the greatest truth ever known to mankind with the greatest lies of mankind in the same truth? I believe in Christmas. I believe in the celebrating the birth of our Lord Jesus and Savior. I believe in giving gifts in his wonderful name. Just as the wise men did 2,000 years ago, I believe he is to be worshipped today as Lord. But I do not think that a myth and a lie should be mixed with the celebration of my Lord's coming. I do not think that is acceptable unto God. Isn't that just like the devil to try and steal away the deity of Christ by mixing it with pagan worship? Some of you will take offense at my words. I do not seek to offend, but rather to set you free from lies and idol worship. And we should have a pure celebration of the risen King's birth. I encourage you to celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Give gifts in his wonderful name. Sing songs and be merry. But don't drag the devil and his lies and myths into the celebration of my Lord's greatest gift to man, to me. Neither shalt thou bring an abomination into thine house, lest thou be a cursed thing like it. But thou shalt utterly detest it, and thou shalt utterly abhor it, for it is a cursed thing. Deuteronomy 7:26.
Praise the Lord. I'm glad you read that, sister. Kind of goes along with our,
does it
our
really?
Teaching today, Deuteronomy 28, because we're going to be talking about blessings and curses. And I have learned over years, praise God, that when I do the will of God, he blesses me.
Amen.
The closer that each of us get to God, and we do that through prayer and supplication, and just sitting down and dwelling, thinking about God, praise God, that's how we get close to God.
Amen.
And when you do that, the first thing God's going to do is ask you to do certain things, because we're servants. I mean, a servant doesn't sit around, you know, telling the master what to do or even telling the other servants what to do. A servant listens to what the master wants and accomplishes that. Praise God. And, you know, the thing about a good master never asks a servant to do something that they're not capable of. So none of us have any reason for sitting back saying, well, I just can't do it. You know, I'm physically disabled, I'm mentally disabled. No, God's got something for you. Praise God. And one of the greatest things in the world is prayer warriors. Praise God. Keeping praising. And we love the fact that many of you are out there praying for our program and this outreach. Praise God. I just want to say that. But we're going to go get some music. Praise
the
Lord. And I hope you enjoy it once again. And right after that, we'll be right back. So praise the Lord. You got anything before we go to it, Sister Karen?
I'm going to tell them to get their Bibles and get you a pencil and a piece of paper.
All right. Praise the Lord. And we'll see you right after this. God bless.
One hammer cast a shadow on the rough, stony ground. It was raised toward the heavens, and all at once it came crashing down. It drove the spike 12 inches long into each tender hand. And nailed to one wooden cross, one guiltless man. One spear was cast in anger into one precious side. Dice were thrown in mockery for his robe just before he died. Two eyes were cast up toward the sky. Forgive them, God, he prayed. And I know it must have rained in heaven on crucifixion day.
All the lights went out Salvation that Jesus brought. The Bible says there's nothing shall separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. We have a wonderful opportunity regardless of where we are in life. The invitation remains. We can set our sails and head toward home.
Set your sails and head for home, you'll find shelter from the storm. There's no need for you to roam. Set your sails and head.
Always always a place that you can come to, where you'll find the rest you need and peace within. And there's always a way for you to get there. Close your eyes and follow him and set your sails and head for home. You'll find shelter from the storm. There's no need for you to roam. Set your sail and head for home. You may feel you've strayed so very far away, and you may think that you're stranded and alone.
But the master of the sea, honey, he knows right where you are, and you are.
Help us sing that wonderful chorus. Set your sail
and head for home.
And head for home.
You'll find shelter from the storm.
You'll find shelter from the storm.
There's no need for you to roam.
There's no need for you. Set your sail
and head for home.
And head for home.
Sing it again, will you?
Set your sail
and head for home.
And head for home.
You'll find shelter from the storm.
You'll find shelter from the storm.
There's no need for you to roam.
There's no need.
not shining, and clouds can tell you rain is soon to fall. But clouds can also have a silver lining, and soon they'll bring the greatest day of all. For the sun will ride on a cloud one day. The Father will say, bring them all home to shade. That cloud will be waiting to take us away. Oh, I'm looking for that cloud today. Teardrops fill their eyes as they stood gazing. They were wondering why their Lord was caught away. Oh, but angels told them, you just keep on praising. This same cloud will come back any day. For the sun will ride on a cloud one day. The Father will say, bring them all home to stay. That cloud will be waiting to take us away. Oh, I'm looking for that.
then I see Calvary, and I'm reminded just how much Jesus loves me. Why, tell me why, did the Son of God suffer? Oh, why was he willing to die? Though often I struggle to answer this question, still I
good music.
Yes.
We got several videos coming up of different groups, and
mm-hmm.
and I think you'll enjoy them too. I know we had the Statler brothers on. Jimmy Fortune was with them, praise the Lord, for many years. And I enjoy Jimmy so much. And all of these people, the wonderful thing that I like about them is they, when you talk, you ain't going to talk to them very long, you're going to be talking about God.
That's
you're going
right.
to be talking about Jesus, praise the Lord. And I love that, praise the Lord. And let me say this, praise God, I love everybody, praise God. I hate the sin that many people are in, praise God, but I love souls, praise God. I said one time to people, I said, I got to love everybody, but I don't have to like a lot of them.
There you go.
But I love souls, and the thing about this program we're trying to get you to do is if you're living in sin, praise God, we like to point out, here's how to get out of that sinful lifestyle. Praise the Lord.
That's what we do.
And when you do, you're going to be so blessed. You're going to have hope. And, you know, that's the thing. Hopelessness has, you know, hopelessness has an odor.
Mm.
You can enter into a home or you can enter into a place and you can literally smell the hopelessness that's there. It's kind of a rotting, decaying smell, praise God. And you can look around and the house may be, or building may be just clean as a pin, but you get, there's that smell. And you realize here's a home without hope, praise God.
And that, without God, and that's what
without
it
God,
down
that's
to.
It. You know, our only hope that we should have is in Christ Jesus, mm-hmm. praise the Lord. Because people can't save you. They can show you how to be saved, and they can help lead you to Christ, but that's the decision that each of us has to make. And that's why we're going to read Deuteronomy 28. We had talked about this before, because here is, if you want to be blessed, then here's how.
Yes.
And we're not going to get through this today, but next time we start on it, we're going to talk about, if you want to be cursed, here's how.
Right. Yeah. Hello.
And I think you'll pick up on this, praise the Lord. So we're going to start here, chapter 28 of Deuteronomy, praise God. And we're going to read and talk about it, praise God, and hope to get you to understand that God, above all things, wants to save your soul. Hallelujah. And he makes a way where there seems
Amen.
To be no way. He makes a way. Praise God.
And it's never a complicated thing.
It's never. He never asks more of you than you're capable of.
Or that you're even willing to understand.
That's it. Praise God. So let's go there. And pray. I'm going to leave the camera on for a little bit for both of us. Praise God. Because I want us to discuss this. So if you'd begin to read there, Sister Carolyn.
And it
verse 1. Yeah, go ahead.
I got it. That's chapter 20.
Yeah.
Deuteronomy. And it shall come to pass, if thou voice of the Lord thy God.
Well.
What did I do?
I don't know.
Shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
Now listen, praise God. God is explaining here, hey, Israel, if you will listen to me, diligently hearken means to sit down and listen to me and then think about it and do it. Unto the voice of the Lord, to observe and to do. We talked about that in church the other day.
Yeah, that's coming up every day.
Yeah, praise God. To know is one thing, but to do. You have to have faith to do, praise God. To observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God shall set thee on high above all the nations of the earth. And what we're reading here are conditions. If the condition applies to Israel, it applies to us.
Yeah.
One God. We serve the same God. God said, I change not. I am God. I cannot lie. Praise God. So verse 2.
And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So you can't stop it.
Wow.
It doesn't say maybe, and all these blessings might come on thee. But no, it says they shall come on you and overtake you. You can't outrun the blessings of
God.
If you will listen and do according to the voice of the Lord thy God. Okay, continue.
That's it. Blessed shalt thou be in the city, and blessed shalt thou be in the field.
Man, you can't go nowhere where God can't find you to bless
you. Either in the city or out of a city.
Praise the Lord.
Blessed shalt be thy fruit of thy body.
See, that's your kids.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And the fruit of thy ground.
Everything that you put in that ground, the seed, the corn, peas, your garden.
Flowers.
Fruit, praise God, yes.
And the fruit of thy cattle.
Don't you just love it? Praise God. All your livestock. Hallelujah. You, farmers, praise, you know what that means. Praise God.
The increase of thy kine.
Praise God.
And the flocks of thy sheep.
See, God wants to bless everything, every aspect. What he said, I want to bless every aspect of your life. And if you want me to, listen to me, hearken to me, and do the things that I'm asking you to do. And if you'll do that, I'll bless you. No matter where you are, I'll even bless your cattle. I'll bless all your animals. And thy basket and thy store. Praise God. That means that's when I have an abundance of stuff and I put it up, you know, we don't have to worry about it rotting on the shelf.
You used to call it a storehouse.
Yeah, a storehouse. Praise God.
All our excess food, pantries in your storehouse and wherever, basement.
And, you know, the thing of it is, when we get in, of course, in New Testament, Old Testament, both, God said, when you see somebody hungry, feed them. That's what your storehouse is for.
That's it.
You know, praise God. And when you do that, according to God's hearken unto me and help other people, then you're going to be blessed in your storehouse. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Go ahead.
Blessed shalt thou be when thou comest in, and blessed shalt thou be when thou goest out.
Inside, outside. Don't make any
coming
difference.
Coming or going,
you're
going to be
coming
blessed.
Coming and going. There you go. I like that. Praise God. 7.
The Lord shall cause thine enemies to rise up against thee Wait a minute. Let me do that. The Lord shall cause thine enemies that rise up against thee to be smitten before thy face.
See, he's saying when you're doing God's work, you don't have to worry about, over in Hebrews and Romans, it talks about the fact You don't worry about government. You don't worry about those things. You just worry about staying close to the Lord, and God will take care of you no matter who's in charge, who's running the government, whatever. Mm-hmm. Praise God, just keep your eyes on God. And don't worry about all that stuff. If they come against you, I'll stop them.
Yeah, it says right here, okay. They shall come out against thee one way and flee before thee seven ways.
Seven ways.
They may come in, but they're going to be scattered out.
That's right.
Out.
You know, it's like I used to call it, we need Teflon faith.
I like
praise
that.
God. Because why you call it Teflon, Brother James? I said, because nothing will stick to Teflon.
Nothing stains and nothing sticks.
That's it. Somebody wants to throw something at you and try to dirty you up and everything, it just slides off. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. And that's where we need to be. Because when we're close to God and we're doing the things which God has commanded us to do, and we listen, hearken, and say, okay, God, here's what you want me to do. Yes, thank you. And then go and do it. God says, now I'll bless you. Not because you believe, but because you did what you believe.
Amen.
Praise God. All right. Verse 8.
The Lord shall command the blessings upon thee in thy storehouses and in all that thou settest thy hand unto. And he shall bless thee in the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee.
Wow. How many... Your storehouse, and in all that thou settest thy hand unto. And he will bless you in the land, and the land which God has given you. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Wow, I like that. 9.
The Lord shall establish thee an holy people unto himself, as he hath sworn unto thee, if thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God and walk in his ways.
Praise the Lord. You know, the other wonderful thing about this, now implying this into the New Testament, there's really only 10 commandments that we have. We find them over in Exodus, praise the Lord, when God gave them to Moses, praise God. But even in the New Testament, it shortens them down to 2. Love thy neighbor, love thy God.
Above all,
and then love your neighbor.
As yourself.
And if you'll just do those two, praise God.
All the others fall right under it.
Everything else will fall into place, praise God. Now, there's 613 commandments in the Old Testament, and there's no way you can keep them all because, let's face it, some of those commandments apply to women. I can't do what you do under the law.
And
you can't do what God requires of me under the law. And both of us can't do what God requires of kings and queens and those things.
Yeah.
Why? Well, we are kings and priests, praise the Lord, unto the Lord, but we're not part of the government. How can that possibly apply? And many of the laws apply to the priests themselves. But, I mean, even if you separated all of them, you still couldn't keep the ones that apply to you. But you can do the ones that Jesus called us to do.
That's right.
Love the Lord and love your neighbor.
That's it.
If you can keep those two, you'll pretty well get through life, praise God, and do what God tells you to do. It's like we were reading there a while ago, when you see somebody in need, praise God, and that's what he's talking about here. Okay, go ahead.
10? Is that where I'm at, 10? And all the people of the earth shall see that thou art called by the name of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee.
Wow. See, he's not saying that they'll be afraid of James.
You.
He's not saying they'll be afraid of Carolyn. What he's saying is when they see God in you, when they see Jesus in you, the fear of coming against God or Jesus will suppress them. I ain't going to mess with that man because he's a man of God.
That's right. That used to mean something.
Yeah, it used to. And if I mess with him, I'm messing with God. You know, there's a lot of things that come into strength when the Bible says that I'm a friend of God. I'm not just a servant. I'm a friend of God. Praise God. Well, friends take care of friends.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I mean, what better friend could you possibly have? Okay. Continue, babe.
11. And the Lord shall make thee plenteous in goods, and in the fruit of thy body, and in the fruit of thy cattle, and in the fruit of thy ground, and in the land which the Lord sware unto thy fathers to give thee.
See, he goes right back over and says, let me say this one more time. Praise the Lord. I want to bless you above all things. I'll bless the fruit of your body, that's your children. I will bless your cattle, your livestock. I'll make sure that they don't starve. I'll make sure that everything comes again. And he proved that in Egypt. Remember?
Yes, he did.
And I don't know how many animals lost their lives when God said that the firstborn, mm-hmm. not just of man, but of all animals, died, except not one single animal died in Goshen,
that's
or
right.
where Israel was.
Or in the Israelites.
God is able. I mean, he made that distinction so clear. Here's Israel, here's the world, and what I do to the world, I'm not going to do to Israel because they're my chosen people. Praise God. Well, folks, I'm God's chosen people. Carolyn is God's chosen people. When you believe Jesus Christ and receive Jesus Christ as Lord and the Savior, you become a part of the family of God. Not just a friend. Mm. Now you are a relative.
Amen.
And there's a lot of friends I have that's closer than some of my relatives. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. But see, God loves you, and he wants, and he's able. Everything there is in this world, all the gold, all the silver, all the diamonds, all the wealth that there is anywhere, all belongs to God. He's just letting us use it for a while.
That's it.
Praise God. When you use it wisely to be a blessing, God blesses you. When you try to hoard it up, God withholds from you. He's saying, well, you think you can do better than I can? Ooh, okay. 12.
Verse 12. The Lord shall open unto thee his good treasure, the heaven to give the rain unto thy land in his season, and to bless all the work of thine hand. And thou shalt lend unto many nations, and thou shalt not borrow.
Listen to that. It means that you'll have the wealth to be able to help other people.
That's right.
You don't have to borrow. You don't have to get.
You got it.
You need not receive anything from your neighbors or anything because you're able to give. Praise God. I like this first part of this because it says, thou shalt open unto thee his good treasure.
Mm.
And when I read that, what I get is a vision of this giant pirate jewelry.
Huge
trunk of jewels. And he just saying, open it up and say, what do you want? Take all you want. Take all you want. Praise God. And you can't, the wealth is just, I don't know, it's just overwhelming.
Yes.
Overwhelming to me to think. Here God is saying unto you, everything that I created is available to you if you want it.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. And knowing that because you are a doer of the word, we were reading that in James 1:22. To be a doer of the word. God knows that when you get all this, all those riches and everything, that you will be a doer of the word and will give that out, help mm-hmm. others with it. Praise God. God can trust you with it. Okay, praise the Lord. Sister Carter, go ahead.
All righty. 13.
13.
And the Lord shall make thee the head and not the tail, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt be above only, and thou shalt not be beneath. If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe and to do them.
And the Lord God himself will make you the head.
Hallelujah.
Well, how does he do that? Well, when I have a faith in God, I don't have to worry about the world running me.
Yeah.
I don't have to worry about Satan running me. As the head, I can say, hey, I'm in charge here.
Mm-hmm.
Leave, Satan. And world, I don't need you. I have God. I don't need the things of the world. I'm so happy with what God has given me. That which the world has is so diminished, it's meaningless.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord. Compared to what God can do for you, folks, praise God, listening, how do we happen? How does it happen, praise God? If that thou hearken unto the commandments of the Lord thy God, which I command thee this day to observe, and what? To do them. There it is again. Not just hearers, but doers. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. 14.
And thou shalt not go aside from any of the words which I command thee this day, to the right hand or to the left, to go after other gods to serve them.
See, that's it. We take God's word at what it means, folks. Praise the Lord. And we don't go looking for something over here. I mean, what in the world can the devil possibly give you? He's there to steal, to kill and destroy.
That's it.
God, on the other hand, says, here, open my hand to you. You're my child. What do you want? Mm-hmm. I mean, riches, good fortune. And let me say this, folks. Praise God. Being rich will not save you. You have to be a believer and a doer in God's word. And we're going to do a program on riches and the deceitfulness of riches, praise God, and wonder why in the world does somebody set out to be a millionaire or a billionaire, praise God, when everything that you want from God is supplied. He said, I will supply all of your needs according to the riches through Christ Jesus.
You know, I'm reminded of a saying I heard someone say, when you're young, you spend all your time and health to get money. And then when you get old, you spend all your money to get time and your health.
Boy, ain't that the truth. Praise God. Praise the Lord.
I said, wow, does that not think, dwell on that a minute or two? Chew on that a little bit.
Praise God. So how do I get blessed?
Yeah, right here.
I listen to what God has to say.
And do it.
And then I do it. Praise God. Well, that's called faith. You just do it because you believe what this book says. You believe what God has said. Praise God. Well, we're running out of time again.
We are Hallelujah. Just about out of time, you
Praise
know.
Praise the Lord. But we're going to continue because I'm going to go over the curses. It's going to take us a couple of weeks to go over the curses. Praise God. God loves you, and he gave his son for you. Praise God. And if you can just believe and receive Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, you too can be blessed and be a doer of the word. Well, praise God.
You know, the most simplest thing that God did for us was to make it where we can accept this easiest thing, simplest, is accept him as your Savior. Just mean it. Just tell the Lord, say, Lord, speak to the Lord and say, I know I'm a sinner. I know I need you in my life. I cannot get to heaven without you. Please come in my heart and change me. That's all a sincerity.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise
all right.
God. We're out of time.
I know.
Praise the Lord. And remember, you shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free. God bless. We'll see you
next week.
God bless.
Chance to be all that I can be. It's gonna be a good day.